Hi and welcome back to the channel. Thought it was about time we went through a few of the little problems that are remaining on the Volvo 480. Also take you through some of the things that I've sorted and also planning on will it start. First things, it's been sat here an awful long time. The paintwork is not doing so good because it's getting a lot of dust and dirt on it. I have given it a little bit of a spray wash and a bit of a clean, but it's still not great. It is going to need a fair bit of detailing, I would have thought, machine polishing, that kind of thing, and then a new like a wax finish on it to try and help it out. Also, where I've repaired the wing here, I didn't put a clear coat on, and you can see what's happened. We've had a bit of a problem with the paint, so I think that as well is going to need sanding back, blending back in again with the colour paint and getting that back right. But that's all kind of minor stuff, because round on the other wing, if you remember, I didn't actually finish painting that wing. But again, I'm not too bothered about that. You can see a little bit of rust starting to creep back through. It's by no means a permanent job that I've done on that, which is a bit disappointing. But generally, the rest of it is back together. You can see the rear bumper is back in place. There's a lot of stuff inside it. I'm just storing a lot of things inside. We go around here. The leaks have all stopped as well. I've managed to sort that. I do need to trim this rubber piece down and fit it. That was where one of the water leaks was coming from. Water was getting in that way and actually straight onto the carpets. Speaking of carpets, if we open it up, you will see, I think it was the last video, I was putting in the underlay and the carpets and then the seats. So the front two seats are in. If you remember, the rear seats I haven't done. That's going to come later on, just once I'm happy that the fuel pump's running and I don't need access anymore. But other than that, those are in place. The door card's still off because I was having a few problems with the window, and I'm going to come onto the window in just a moment. That's the electric windows and the sunroof as well. Climbing inside, you can see most of the dashboard is actually in place. Got a few little screws and things to finish off, but generally I've put most of the switches and buttons and controls back in. Center console, window switches, mirror switches. Now we are having problems with the info center, so this is going to have to come back out, but for the moment it's not too bad. Now if I pop the keys in, if I just get the camera to adjust and I'll turn the ignition on, you may have heard the fuel pump prime away there, and you can see dashboard lights come on, lambda light, that should go out in a second, so did the airbag light, which is all good news. We've got a check bulb warning light, which I'd expect because we do have quite a few bulbs that are out at the moment. And now onto some of the problems. I thought that I'd got the windows and a few of the electrics working. However, the sunroof doesn't do anything anymore. Neither do the windows. So I've been looking through the fuses. I've got the fuse box down the bottom here. And all the fuses are fine, so I'm not quite sure what's going on there. That's something to look into. A few of the other things that that do work, the fan works, which is good. I'll turn that off so we don't have noise. The double indicators, they do actually work. However, the direction indicators don't. That's a little bit of an unusual one. I'm not quite sure what's going on there. Need to look at that. The lights, let's try the pop-up lights. So you can see the pop-up lights are working, the motors, which is good news. I am starting to suspect something wrong in the stalk though, because what's happening is when I'm pulling on it, which should just be to flash the lights, you might be able to see the reflection in the Duke, the lights are actually staying on. So there's something possibly not quite right in the stalk here. I'm hoping it's just the stalk that's got a problem. As well, the radio is not coming on either. Again, I've checked the fuses and that all seems fine. So there is some sort of an electrical gremlin going on that I need to track down. But those are all kind of extra things, really. The main one that I've been looking at is the engine. What I did earlier on is I've filled the coolant back up again. So when I had the coolant, the pump off, obviously I lost quite a bit of water and also got air in the system. So I filled the coolant up and you can see just there, that is the bleed screw. It's attached onto the internal heater matrix. So you undo that and I was getting air out of there. Ran that for a while, also pumped the radiator hose down the bottom, and when coolant started coming out, that looks like we've got a full system of coolant in, which is good. You'll notice that the spark plugs are back on. Put those in, torque them up, and also checked the oil. Now I did replace the oil a while back and I've checked the dipstick, it's looking nice and clean and all good, so I'm quite happy with that. I think that is pretty much good to go. The tensioner, I put the tensioner on, that's fastened up, so I think everything in the engine bay is buttoned up and ready to go. Something I did forget to mention, I do need to bleed the brakes, because the brakes are just dropping to the floor at the moment. That's a job that I need to do with another pair of hands in the car, because I think although I've got the pressure bleeder, I think it'll be easier to do it just by the old method of pumping the brakes. And with all of that in place, I'm fairly happy that I think we can try and start it up, which will be the first start that this has had in a lot of years. Whether it'll start or not, I'm not really sure. I'm not sure how it'll sound or what problems we'll have. So I'm going to set the cameras up and let's see if it'll start. Right then, let's see what happens here. The ignition on, fuel pump is primed. Let's try turning it over. That was close, it almost started. Well, that was quite an uneventful first start. We've got a fair old exhaust leak somewhere, but that is running really smoothly considering this car hasn't ran in a very, very long time. Oil light has gone out, which is good, so we've got oil pressure. And actually we've got no warnings on the dash at all. That's a very big exhaust leak, unfortunately. Now I'm going to try a little bit of reverse. Because this car hasn't moved under its own power in a long time. Okay, that's just the axle stands, but that's actually running okay. It's smelling a little bit rich, which is kind of also expected. I wonder where that exhaust leak's coming from. Oh, it's right at the front. Hopefully it's not the manifold. It does sound like it's at the manifold level, which is a bit of a pain if that's the case. But I think for a first start in a long time, I'm really quite happy with that. I'll take you for a quick walk round before we stop. Everything fairly happy in there. Got our tail lights on as well. So far, only one of our two number plate lights have come on. Those are the LED ones that I replaced. Like I say, no warning lights. Still no indicators. We do have a bit of a petrol smell in here. So I will be checking the fuel pump to make sure that there's nothing wrong there. But otherwise, I would say that is a really successful first run in a very long time. Well, after a very promising start that was. We've got a very strong smell of petrol. Doesn't look like it's on the fuel filter, fuel pump at the top. But the fuel filter, I think, is the suspect. So, if you remember, I did actually think this was going to be a problem because I couldn't get the fuel filter off. The fittings seemingly aren't easily got hold of either. So, we've got a fuel leak. Okay, that's not good. Right, we're not going to be running this up again in any time soon because that's really not good news. We've got a bit of fuel not on the pipe, so I don't think it was spurting out. And it doesn't feel like there is a foam pipe here. It doesn't feel like the foam pipe is saturated, so I don't think it's coming from higher up and leaking down. I think it's around this fitting, which, like I say, wouldn't surprise me. The fuel filter is a bit of a problem. I do have a new one. Tell you what, let me show you the new filter. Borgenbeck fuel filter. You can see it's a can. Direction of flow is that way. And you can see the type of fittings that are on it. It's exactly the same. The problem being, on the existing one, on the car, I suspect they've almost metal welded themselves together. Trying to get them undone was almost impossible. Also, there's nothing really easy to grip. You see, you do have that outer and then a nut on the inner to try, but again, it's not easy to do. I think what we're going to have to do is get the back of the car jacked up into the air. There's some copper crush washers in there as well for the ends. And attempt this, because I think we've got a leak on that. We really want to replace the fuel filter as well. I did put that off. I think that's something we need to tackle, especially with the fumes that I'm smelling. Yeah, just looking. There's no fuel leaked around here. It would normally sort of pool in the top and you would see it. And I'm not seeing any. I don't think it's coming from the top. I think it is down at the fuel filter, because obviously it feeds down from the fuel pump down to the filter and then towards the engine bay. I think that's our problem. And that is our next fix to get that resolved, because that is a major problem. You can also see it's not that far off the exhaust either. And although we've got that exhaust blow, I'm not as worried about that as I am about a fuel leak. So we need to get the car up in the air, and we need to take a look at the fuel fittings and see what we have to do. If all else fails, we may need to remake part of the fuel line, which of course is more awkward now because it's all full of fuel. So I need to have a think on how to solve this one. You can see there, I've given it a good spray with WD-40 to try and loosen those fittings, because those fittings are in a pretty bad state. I'm not sure whether I'm going to be able to get them undone easily. If not, it might be a case of actually cutting the pipe back and putting a completely new fitting on the end. But I'm going to leave those to soak, probably give them a few days, give them another soak, try again, see if I can get them off. Also, I'm not convinced that the new filter has got the right unions on the end either. I don't have any, so I'm going to have to look and maybe buy a couple of pipe unions to do that. I think that's probably something I'm going to have to do in the future. So for now, we're not going to be doing any more starting. And that's probably about all that I'm going to update you on for the moment on the Volvo. We did get a positive start of the engine, which is great news. Running really smoothly as well, so I'm not too worried about that. It's running quite happily. So that is all we're going to do on the Volvo this time round. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Pop a like and a comment down the bottom. It really helps the channel out if you could do that. And I'll see you in the next video.